wakati wa maana. Mko tayari? Mko tayari? Mko tayari? Mnataka baba atangaze? Mnataka nitangaze? Mko tayari? Mko tayari? Kwa mimi nasema mimi mkiwa mnataka mimi nitaona hapo huko mbele.
Kaleta kitu naitwa Ruwaza 2030 Vision 2030 ya kupigana na ukosefu wa kazi. Sasa Uhuru wamejaribu, lakini kumekuwa na mvurutano hapa na pale pande ile. Tumeona yale umeona? Simeona? Sasa sisi tunasema tunaweza kubadilisha hali ya uchumi ya taifa letu.
Sasa kama mimi naambiwa ati Raila atakikana Mlima Kenya, nimefanya makosa gani? Nimeimba nini? Mimi nimerudi kuongea mara hii na wakaji wa Mlima Kenya na vijana. Tabia vijana kama kumepambauka.
Baba, kwa sababu tunajua wewe wakati utatangaza kwamba utawania kiti cha urais, ukija hapa tutakuangalia kwa yale macho mazuri.
That is Raila Odinga. Of course, he had been in like KPF for about 3 days, and that is on his way back, stopovers all the way from Nyeri to Githurai, and we'll be looking at the pictures later on. But also Deputy President William Ruto has been speaking about the United Democratic Alliance, that is UDA, and they are promising that there will be free and fair nominations. Listen.
We know the history has not been very good for the political parties, but UDA will turn the page. The way UDA has grown by the grace of God, we will make sure everybody belongs. Nobody will be more important than the other. We will have something called the level playing field.
The matter of free and fair nominations is not a favor from the party. It is a right to every member of this party. It is the irreducible minimum that any member can ask of this party, that if they have political aspirations, they must have the space, they must have the democratic right, and they must have the fairness to be able to compete in this party in a manner that everybody is equal.
All right, and that is the Deputy President William Ruto. They are speaking just after Veronica Maina, who is the Secretary General of the UDA party. And there are two issues that come from there. Of course, so many candidates that are running in this election, including Musalia Mudavadi, Kalonzo Musyoka, Justin Muturi, Ruben Kigame. We have Mukhisa Kituyi, you have the Governor of Makueni, Kivutha Kibwana, and so many more. But two issues that we want us to talk about, that is the lessons that we learned in the 2017 nominations, which were pretty chaotic, especially for the ODM and the Jubilee Party, and also the politics of exclusion that have sort of influenced conversations every election cycle in this country. And I'll begin with you, Honorable Dan Manzo. You don't have a lot of challenges with nominations in WIPO. I don't know how exactly you do that. But Sifu, are you laughing? But as you reflect on this, at a time that there will be that possibility of parties coming together to form coalitions, already your party is working with Ford Kenya and KANU under One Kenya Alliance, and there may be competing interests, obviously. How best do you suggest we go into this? Because the elections are made or destroyed starting from nominations, especially for political party cohesion.
Yes, that is very true. And although I've seen the Deputy President promising in his party free and fair nominations, it's a very tricky thing because it begins with the party leadership itself. A lot of people go to lobby with the party leader, and at the same time, the people have their own choice also. And a lot of times you find even rigging takes place during nominations, and a lot of times you may have end up the wrong candidate even getting the certificate. At times also, you get the certificate of the party, and by the time you get to IBC, somebody else has already been cleared with the same certificate from a party. And I think this is corruption at the lowest level. and at a political level, and that's where actually corruption begins. We have to come up with a structure to make sure that whoever is the right candidate really deserves it. And what happens after the fallout? You find somebody goes now into independent candidature because you cannot shift parties at that during nominations. I'm aware this way in parliament, 70% doesn't come back. Mm-hmm. You've gone, you've lost the nominations, you try independence, it doesn't work, and you never end up back to parliament. So it's very competitive in quite a number of parties, and it is somebody, the party leadership itself must do what they speak, mm-hmm. and make sure that they are honest to their candidates, and nothing really goes wrong with that. And a lot of times, when you lose or your party nomination is stolen, mm-hmm. then you never find a chance again in leadership. Surviving as an independent candidate is really tricky at the general elections. So I think this is something political party leaders, mm-hmm. and unfortunately, that's where we are. You know, the political party leader is very, very important. They should give the people freedom to choose the candidates, and the candidates who have come from the people should be the ones to be cleared. But it's usually messy. It ends up in court, okay. ends up in tribunals. The law is also not clear. You know, at that particular moment, having lost the nomination, it's not really an election petition. So there's a lot to be done there, especially when we look in the reforming of electoral law and even future reformation of the constitution. Mm-hmm. We must address the nominations. It's really chaotic.
Okay, and allow me to first get to Honorable Onyonka here, because you've fallen victim
yes.
at nominations level previously.
Yes.
I don't know how many parties you've run on
Three.
Since 2007.
Three.
So which part was it, 2007?
I first of all got nominated by ODM. I went for nominations with ODM in 2007. Mm-hmm. Then I believed at the time that I was rigged out. After that, the law was very, very fair mm-hmm. to those who lost nominations. Then I immediately moved over to PDP, which was a party at that time, which was owned by former Member of Parliament, Omingo Magara.
You just say owned.
I then became the only MP in Parliament for uh-huh. PDP, but at that time I was working with ODM. Uh-huh. Then
2013.
When I finished the first term, on my second term, now ODM was willing to accommodate me.
Did you go to nominations?
No, I didn't go to nominations. Actually, nomination. They called me and said, would you want us to give you a party ticket? I think the relationship between me and the Prime Minister had become very, very good, because he had appointed me an assistant minister then. Mm-hmm. But of course, you know, my vote, which was the only vote, is the one which made Marende become the speaker. Mm-hmm. So there was a quid pro quo thing. Then when now I have finished my second term, mm-hmm. I find that ODM has reinvented an MCA to run against me, right?
And the nominations.
The nominations. Uh-huh. And when you do your strategic thinking and evaluation, I realized, if an MCA defeats you, by the time you've come back to go and appeal and go to court, you've lost the elections. Uh-huh. So I left and joined Jaramogi's party, uh-huh. which is Ford Kenya, uh-huh. and I got elected.
And 2022?
2022, we are persuading my brother, the SG, and in fact, I've been talking with the Prime Minister, who's somebody I highly, highly regard, mm-hmm. That we are waiting to see which way to go. If again we find that these issues, and SG, this is something you people really, really have to really seriously look at. Create a scenario where your nominations are as good as they can be. This business of people exchanging money, and truthfully, like your party leader Kalonzo, may not know, or sometimes even my party leader Moses Wetangula may not know that money is exchanging hands under them. Mm. But you'll find people are running, they're chasing after the undertakers of the party leaders. Money is moving up and down. People ran out of offices. The last nominations of ODM, when I was trying to chase, people were running, I think, to South Sea, some office. You are being told, do you see that man who's there? Yes, go and see him and discuss, you know, that. We have to stop that. It is not, I mean, you see, the deputy president has talked about it in, on UDA. That is the fear everybody has got.
But Honorable Onyonka, I find that interesting because I've asked you a question on where you're headed in 2022. You are the deputy party leader of Ford Kenya.
Yes.
But I'm still saying that you're waiting to see where to go.
I'll tell you this. But thank you. That's a very good question. Let me answer you. Politics is local.
Yeah, yeah.
The Kenya political parties, we have no ideology. I mean, I would lie to you here saying that I believe in the green movement. I believe in equity and fairness, all those things. Where it is, the question is very simple. What are my people talking about? Right now in Kisii, ODM is a very popular party. But the Kisii community is asking itself questions, and we are saying, what is the possibility that we can create our own party, which then can work with ODM, which then can make the community negotiate? Because this is where Kenya is now. This is not, Sam, this is not a charade. This is not a
story.
You
don't see a future of yourself in Ford Kenya and Kitutu Church South?
Absolutely not. I have to be candid with you. I mean, I am the only member of parliament in Kisii. Ford Kenya doesn't have a single MCA in Kitutu Church South. The possibility of Ford Kenya winning an electoral position other than the two seats we have gotten in Kisii. Are you with me? I love my party leader. I respect him sincerely. I have worked with him wonderfully. But my politics is based on reality. Look at what is happening right now. People in northern Kenya are coming up with a new outfit. Why? The people of Coast, they mean, and this is where I'm going to talk to my brother SG and my brother Manzo. Manzo, you see, the truth is very simple. There are people who are willing to support Kalonzo Musyoka. There are people who are willing to support Raila. Stop giving us this argument that you think that if we have our own political party, then we are going to jeopardize the success and the growth of the party. These parties have been known to betray the interests of certain communities. And not because the parties are bad, and not because of selfish interest, because the politics mutates and changes in Kenya as often as you can imagine. So what we are saying, make your people, your honchos on the ground, please persuade them not to fight us because we are supporting your presidential candidate.
Okay.
But if you guys, if ODM is going to pick a war with us just because we are saying we are Kenya, it is a very unfortunate argument I'm going to make here. Kenya is a tribal nation of small nation states. Let us first acknowledge that. If we agree to... Kalonzo Musyoka has got 1 million votes from Eastern Kenya. That is what makes him a national leader. If he didn't have any, who would care to listen to him? Are we getting it? So my point is very simple. Let us not trivialize this issue of we are not tribal, or you know, we believe in ideology and Kenya is a greater nation for all of us. We are only Kenyans when guys are running in Qatar. And they're number 1, 3, and 4. And when Harambee Stars are scored
and Onyonka, before I get to Sifuna, when are you leaving Fort Kenya?
I will leave it when I have consulted with my party leader and I've found where to go.
That is very interesting because on this show,
yes,
Governor Iguru told me that she's listening to the ground.
Yes.
Last week, it was actually about 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Yes.
Last week, we saw her in Kirinyaga listening to the people.
Yes.
And they said that they want her to go to UDA.
Yes.
And she said, nyinyi ndio mmesema.
Yes.
So, of course, the major pronouncements are made on this show. But SG Sifuna, you listen to what Honorable Onyonka is saying. And I remember there's a time after the 2017 elections, you had a retreat somewhere, was it Naivasha?
Yeah.
And you came up with a report on how to correct the mistakes. Have we learned that lesson? Because we know that this, especially the major political parties in this country, have big challenges when it comes to nominations. I was in Migori in 2017. I think it was in April or May. And went to the nominations, not myself, but as you covered. And then after the end of the day, there were two winners declared. There was Governor Bado and there was Ochilo Ayako by a parallel team. What have you done to to correct these mistakes to ensure that people who should actually be on the ballot are the people on the ballot under ODM?
Okay, it's a very long story, and I'm going to be as candid as my brother there. Mm-hmm. I don't know if, are we still going to talk about my weekend in Mount Kenya? Forgotten about that.
No, just yes. Carry on.
We'll come back because yes. There's a few things I wanted to say. Uh-huh. But let me start with what my brother Onyonka is saying. Sam, do you know the people responsible for shambolic party nominations? They are the aspirants and their supporters. Mm. We have demonized people who are like, in my party, they demonized the former chair of the board, Honorable Pareno. Mm-hmm. You can't show me a single photograph of Pareno kicking a ballot box. But I can show you dozens of aspirants, some of them are members of parliament right now, planning attacks on where the elections board is storing material, drawing guns when the balloting is about to start, shooting in the air, hiring goons to pull down tents, to kick ballot boxes. Yeah. The problem, and this is something that everybody in the political circles knows, nobody wants to go to party primaries.
True.
When you hear Onyonka say he wants to talk to Sifuna, he wants to talk to my party leader, he wants a direct ticket. Honorable Onyonka, when you say ODM is popular on the ground in Kisii, there are people who have been working all this time when you have been deputy party leader of Ford Kenya. There have been people in ODM working to make the party popular. It just doesn't happen. So those people have a right to say, Sifuna, we are the ones who have been working to make the party popular. Please give us an opportunity also to run for the seat against Honorable Onyonka. What we are saying is it is possible. And you see, the beauty is that on this table and in this country, we are the only party that even attempts these things. We try them, some. Even if DP Ruto pontificates there, everybody knows he has already endorsed people like Kang'ata. He has candidates across the country for governorship of Murang'a, for instance. We are the only party that has a consistent history of trying to do these things. Look at the past by-elections that we have had. When have you ever had, even this UDA?
There is an endorsement, a ticket.
Just a question. I will come to that. I will explain these things to you. If you look at all the previous by-elections we have had since 2017, when has UDA ever done party nominations? They don't even try. In Matungu, they gave a direct ticket. In Kiambaa, they gave a direct ticket. We have political parties that hand certificates to people in bars at night, which is something if ODM ever tried, we would be crucified on shows such as yours, Sam.
But ODM so has been blamed for that too.
Here's the
ODM
thing.
ODM has been blamed for that.
Here's the thing. Mm-hmm. We, and I've sat on this chair many times from 2017, we have acknowledged that there were deficiencies in our system. We have listened to our people. The first thing I ever did as SG of ODM was to put together that MoMA task force. It went across the country and it indicted the party, the leadership of the party, the membership of the party, from top to bottom. And we put in place things. They are the recommendations you saw from MoMA's task force. They wanted a new board. Our members wanted a new board. We have a new board. That is what they said they wanted to see. They wanted to see certain changes in the way things are done. Mm-hmm. If you look at the nominations we've conducted subsequent to the reforms that have happened in the party from 2017, you will see that there is an attempt to actually move away from some of these things. We need the cooperation of the aspirants and their supporters. Mm-hmm. Honorable Onyonka, I am telling you the truth because even I remember when we were trying to put together a new board, people were actually scared of being members of a board because they could see the things that aspirants had done to mm-hmm. previous board members. So mm-hmm. we have set out clearly under ODM that there are four ways of nominating candidates. Mm-hmm. Once this message sinks in people's heads, I think we will have a very easy time. Mm-hmm. The direct ticket is actually under the rules of nomination of the party. That direct ticket is informed by science, the way that we did in Bonchari. The science was showing us that if you give Pavel Oimeke the ticket, because of the clan arithmetic in Bonchari, he was going to win. We were crucified, including by your station here, by saying, oh, you've given the ticket to somebody with a corruption case. But science does not lie. The numbers do not lie. Oimeke was going to win, and we made a pragmatic decision to give him the ticket. I want to assure anybody who wants to be a candidate for ODM. Mm-hmm. Number one, there will be no favors. Please, Onyonka, don't ask for favors.
No, I'm not asking.
Allow. That's what I'm saying. I'm coming to
give me a right of
I'm
reply.
To it.
Give me a right.
You will reply, but
I am not.
Including
to
Sifuna. Even me. Even me.
In fact, so I don't want to go back to ODM.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
Just
I don't want to go back to ODM.
I am coming to that.
All right, Onyonka, we heard you.
I am coming to that. I am just saying.
I'm willing to work with you.
I am just saying. All aspirants deserve a chance. Don't look at an MCA Umdarau. please, he might be the most popular candidate and might deliver the seat for us. Be willing to participate in the processes, because when you sign up to be a member of a party, you are signing up to the rules of that party. Mm-hmm. So the second one, Sam, mm-hmm. you could actually allow for consensus to happen. If there's three people in this room who want to be senator for Nairobi, you can allow them to sit and discuss and talk and say, let's support Sifuna for this one term, and maybe the other term it will be my turn. There's also the delegate system. We have tried it. We tried it in the by-election in 2015 in Homa Bay. Mm-hmm. And again, it was the aspirants with their money cutting away delegates to foreign lands, so you to Tanzania, so you to where? Hiding. Yeah, I mean, if as politicians we don't want to look in the mirror and accept that we are the problem, okay, then we are not going to succeed. Let me just finally, the question of political parties. The fourth means of nomination is the one that all people in the media are obsessed with. The one that is universal suffrage, where you want to see people lining up to vote. Mm-hmm. I am telling you, as a party, we are prepared to make pragmatic decisions. We don't care how we will be judged. We will just say that in Kitutu Chache South, if we give Onyonka the ticket, the science shows me that he will win. I will give the ticket. I don't care what you say about me. It is a fair process. It is a verifiable process. It's a justifiable process.
So you will not necessarily go the universal suffrage?
Yes, because we have said we have four ways.
Okay. All right.
Finally, on the question of other political parties supporting us, Honorable Onyonka,
yes,
it is our constitution that requires that we have national political parties. It is the constitution that proscribes having regional or tribal political parties.
Can I respond to that?
You will.
So, what we have done, Honorable Onyonka, as ODM, we have said that we are willing to work with every person who wants to support us. You saw us in Mount Kenya having a meeting with PNU. We are looking for new partners. We don't have a problem with that. But it cannot be wrong for us to encourage that in the spirit of the constitution, mm-hmm. we build strong political parties. We move away from tribal associations.
Can I? Okay.
The fact that Kenya is a tribal society does not mean that we cannot do...
All right.
You and me belong to a different generation, Honorable Onyonka. Please, let us envision a new country. But
No. That's hypothetical. That's hypothetical.
SG Sifuna, Honorable Onyonka.
Sam.
Just hold on. Let's listen to CAS because she's also here. And CAS, when you listen to this, one of the challenges in 2017, because your political party, the Jubilee Party, you went to the nominations, and of course people had seen what was going on with ODM, and they were saying that probably Jubilee will get it right, and then they didn't. They called off the nomination exercise. You remember some late evening press conference, and the following day or some few days later we saw the deputy president presiding over nominations across different parts of the country. But the challenge of universal suffrage is in the register of political parties. Of course, when you go out, you see the register being used is the IEBC register. These are not members of the party. So what are political parties doing to correct this, to ensure that you have a credible register of voters, members of the party that would participate in such a universal suffrage?
First of all, I think, let me give an example of Jubilee now in 2017. Mm-hmm. Jubilee in 2017, the first nominations they did were nominations where sort of were free, because and the worst was they were using what we call the party, the IEBC register, mm-hmm. which is very wrong. If a political party, and that's why sometimes we look at ODM and we appreciate some of their processes. If you are a political party, the first thing you must have is a register of your political party, your members. And if it is fair enough, put them per county. Have a register of 47 counties of your party members. Mm-hmm. So that when you're going for your nominations, the first thing that tells you an ODM member is entering into a hall mm-hmm. is the register of the political party. Now, when we were, as Jubilee, I know we didn't have that. And so we had to go for the register of IEBC. That was now the nightmare of every aspirant, especially in Mount Kenya. And I remember we did the elections, finished, but at around those who felt, oh, so-and-so has won and was not supposed to win, mm-hmm. they just decided and they called and they say, no, this thing has not worked. And by two or three, the same secretariat team that was manning the elections mm-hmm. decided to start now hiding the booklets, because what they were supposed to do has not happened. Mm-hmm. So you hide, and so people are on the line, but you don't have booklets. So you decide, you say this is a shambo, so that you repeat, so that you get your results. Right. So I prefer what ODM is saying. You'd rather even look at the member and say, we are in consensus.
Yeah.
Science says an opinion says here, this is the guy who is popular, than doing what Jubilee did. And when I look at even how they are planning now, the big parties, those who are in Jubilee, I sympathize because the same secretariat has moved across again, meaning you have not removed the problem. You have gone with the problem again. That same secretariat that takes money like this, and then it comes and decides, today Elachi is the one who is winning, and they will do anything.
How did you become the candidate for Dagoretti North?
Well, you know, I was very stubborn. I was stubborn. And I'll be honest today on this show. I remember my deputy president telling me, you are a Kikuyu and you'll not win this seat. I told him, I'm a Luya, so I'm going for this seat. And so for them, they never wanted to invest in me. And I thank God, I never spent their money. Nobody invested because they told me that is a seat we are going to lose. Now when they realized I got 36,000, they were very shocked again. Said, oh, we wish we helped this lady. So I was given a candidate, a real Luya man. When we went to nominations, I got 13,000, he got 1,000. After that, they took me through a tribunal. That is why people run away from big parties.
Correct.
So I go to a tribunal for 1 week because I am not the right candidate. But they are unable to do it the ODM way and say, science says he's a lawyer and you are not a better lawyer. So take this. Because that is all they were saying.
Honorable Manzo,
yes.
How will you differentiate between science and financing? Because if you can buy the ticket, science might be in favor of you.
No.
How do you differentiate? No, I'm just asking a question because there are things that have happened in this country.
Please, don't reinforce those stereotypes about political parties. Science is universal.
SGSFONA, what I'm asking is, if you say that you're going to use science, how do you ring fence it to ensure that the question of who can finance the party more does not end up getting the ticket?
Or who can finance the science?
Yes.
Because the science,
yeah.
That opinion poll can be influenced.
Can be manipulated.
It can be manipulated a lot of times. There are times opinion polls are not manipulated. But during political times, or when a candidate want to be declared is the one who is fit scientifically, they will also manipulate the poll.
We will tell you.
Therefore, I really want to say there are no clear lines. It's, mm-hmm. It's a really tricky situation. But the good thing is, a good candidate, so somebody who is really scientifically correct, will at times survive the political wave. They'll go independent in a place which is one party really dominated and still win because the people love them. And a lot of times now, when they move, they say, I am independent ODM. So they still are independent Wiper or independent Jubilee, uh-huh. Independent all this. Party and another. And the moment they use that, then they still hang on into the main party where they were kicked out. Mm-hmm. So I think we really need to, political parties need to sit down,
okay.
And come up with a formula. Because as you have heard Honorable Elachi said, you lose the nominations and you go into tribunals, you waste a lot of time. From tribunal, you go to high court and you can't get anywhere with that process. And at the same time, the election is nearing, mm-hmm. And you are busy doing court fights while other people are campaigning. So it is an area we really need to go back and get the best model so that it can be used by political parties for free and fair nominations. And the way the deputy president was saying, uh-huh. He was just speaking from his mouth. He's already determined some people already. He's already has a list and he's going to send the people to nominations knowing who his people are. And even some of people who think are his friend, they are going to lose the election because they are not in his list.
Very interesting. And I know that Honorable Nyonka and Honorable Sifuna, you have some pending matters. But as we wait for that, let's listen to a clip here. Something that happened towards the end of last week. It was in Laikipia by some leaders from Mount Kenya. Listen.
So I'm calling upon my sister Mother Karua, Mwangi Kionjori, na wale wengine akina Munya na Kabogo. Wacheni kuconcentrate na kulialia, kushindanga mukisema, munashurutishwa mvunje chama. Nyinyi tengezeni sera zenu. Ingieni kwa ground, ongeeni na watu ya kanisa, ongeeni na raia wawakubali. Kwa sababu, kompeni kompero safi. Lakini tumekuja pamoja, sababu iko mambo, tusipojipanga, tutapangwa. Tukishajipanga kwa hiyo mambo, kila mtu aende kwa chama yake, akapigie chama yake ndebe. Kila mtu aende kwa mlengo wake.
Wale ambao wana vyama. I think I want to tell you to go back and find out why parties are formed. parties are formed to get power. Hakuna party inatengenezwa ati ya kununua mikate.
Siwezi sema farasi ni wawili au farasi ni mmoja. It is too early. Wale na wao wamekaribia rais, akina Kanini Kega huko hapa. Muache kudanganya Uhuru ground ni mbaya na raia wanaumia. Wanaumia, hiyo ndio ukweli. Raia wanaumia. Nasema hivyo kwa sababu iko mabroka, ukipigiwa simu na Uhuru na Zururo ukiambia watu niliongea na Uhuru jana usiku. Kama mliongea, bona hujamwambia mafuta imepanda bei na gas?
Okay, different leaders there speaking, but at the bottom of it is the situation that Mount Kenya finds itself in. And SG Sifuna, of course, your party leader is saying, they said that I am not acceptable in Mount Kenya and asking the question why. But it's also that struggle of smaller parties trying to survive the national political wave that may come, or political waves that may come. Mm. So how do we go through this process without the politics of exclusion, especially if you have to nurture parties, whether small or big, as vehicles of democracy in this country?
Well, first, ODM has a history of working with other political parties, so that even now the message that we are sending is that we are prepared to work with other political parties. There's nothing wrong, but we must be at the forefront of encouraging the growth of you know, national political parties. I want to say that I had a very interesting weekend out in Nanyuki. We had one meeting where we had young people sit with the Honorable Raila Odinga and just tell us about the experience of him. And we passed the mic around, and it was a very interesting conversation about how just how deeply the demonization of Raila Odinga in Central Kenya has gone. So they were telling us that when they were kids, they would be told, if you don't finish your porridge, Raila Odinga will come for you. It's the same thing. I remember when we were growing up, there used to be these shows on TV for Dracula and the other ones, which you called Omen. There was this guy who was supposedly so bad, he was a devil himself. He would walk into a church, and you know that water that is usually at the door, you dip your finger and you check yourself, you cross yourself. It starts boiling, you know, and you had to show him a cross or a Bible, and then he would disappear. And we were wondering, you know, this demonization has gone on so deep, and that is why Raila was asking himself, what is it that I have ever done to deserve being told that, oh, the people of Central Kenya, you know, do not want you? So what has happened is, as ODM, we have made a deliberate decision, first of all, to free the space around Raila, because those of us who know him know that he is nothing as bad as the people say that he is. So we allow other people to also experience him, and that is why you saw us taking him, or him being taken to Mount Kenya. We want to thank the leadership there, because this is not something that we take for granted. Mm-hmm. The governor of Laikipia was a very honorable host. The other governors in Mount Kenya, the young people, the leaders in the church. So it is like for us now, we don't see this as a victory. No, nobody is proclaiming that now the mountain is conquered. No, this is just the beginning of a conversation with the people of Central Kenya to show them that indeed it is possible for us to work together and to move this country forward. We have made a decision as well, Sam, to put unity and peace as our basis for all development. This is our platform. It might not be as catchy as the others that are being thrown out, but we honestly believe that fundamentally, for as long as the people of this country are in unity and living in peace, then you can talk about those economic models that you want to talk. Because in the absence of that, we have asked the question again, which economic model can you take to Somalia, for instance? There's no economic model you can discuss with them. Look at what has happened recently in Afghanistan. Can you sit the Taliban around the table to discuss an economic model? Mm-hmm. They will not. It cannot happen.
Right.
So we want this country united, we want this country peaceful, and that is the basis of any development that can be achieved in this country.
And Honorable Nyonka, it should appear that in this country, yes, politics is can be divisive and polarized sometimes, but many Kenyans will tell you that it is you guys, the politicians, who are the problem, because you're the ones who will find a name for each other. You know the names that Raila Odinga and Uhuru Kenyatta chose for each other in 2017 election. Yeah. There are already some names coming up. It's only that I can't repeat them, coming up in the current process. So how do you ensure that on the side of politicians, you conduct your campaigns in a responsible manner, knowing that life does not end or start on August 9th, 2022?
The problem with our country, of course, is our politics. the politics whereby we hold elections. In fact, my mind is already flashed over to next year, September. Once the elections are held, the results will come out. Most likely by December, we'd have had a winner. After that, we then start campaigns immediately. In fact, one of the biggest thoughts I've been having lately is we need to go back and look at what the international best practices are. The Kenyan economic cycle is supposed to last a period of 5 years. Mm-hmm. But because of the way we conduct our elections, the first year and the last year, there's no activity. So actually, our economic cycle is 3 years. Shouldn't we start thinking about extending a period to 7 years? Because we begin the year, of course, after the elections, we start talking about development, whatnot. Immediately, it hardly takes a year and a half. Guys already started talking about how we are going to do this and that kind of thing. Point number two, our politics is very toxic for the simple reason that we have refused to actually accept that one of the inherent malfunctions of our politics and our history is based on our tribalism. And my belief now is that if we begin to deal with it honestly and sincerely, and I want to give my brother credit to the Prime Minister. He's always tried to accommodate, and I've talked about this publicly. He's tried to accommodate Kenyans as Kenyans. Mm. And yet in reality, deep down, it's out here, superficially, we are Kenyans, yes. But why is it that when somebody takes over power in this country, he will appoint 19 members from his community to take care of his side of the government? All right. Why is it that when public appointments are being done, you will find, and I have to make this confession, every time I look at the list, Mr. Sifuna, I see Sifuna, I see Maanzo, I see Elachi, I ask, why is there no Kisi name? I never ask whether that Kisi was not there because he's qualified or not qualified. So there are challenges as a country that we must face openly and directly. Even the law of the independent commission that deals with fairness and equity in terms of
gender and equality.
Yes, National Gender and Equality Commission. Mm-hmm. We have the 30% which was supposed to go to the county governments. I will ask you, Sifuna, ODM, I have told you, I have no fight with ODM, but ask yourself, how many ODM governors allowed other Kenyans to take 30% of those jobs in the county governments? Mm. None. So in other words, even when we are struggling, and I'm very cautious not to blame anybody, mm-hmm. we need to start looking at our country and our politics in such a manner that we can actually stop the toxicity and make sure that the country moves forward. I am so happy what I'm seeing in Central. I am seeing the deputy president there. I'm seeing Raila there. I want to see Kalonzo there. That will most probably bring down the annoyance, the hate, and the vitriol that is always thrown out at politicians and our people.
All right. And C.S. Elachi, yesterday, the Member of Parliament for Ugunja, Opiyo Wandayi, released some proposed amendments to different laws, including the elections law, to say that any person who's been charged on account of corruption and has taken plea should not be cleared to run for office. I don't know what your reflections are on that. But as you respond to that, maybe also you can tell us about how we fix this country through this election by making sure that that politics of exclusion does not hit us again like what happened in 2017.
First of all, Opiyo and I think it is important because I think what we have realized is that in our country it is like this issue. In fact, we need to ask ourselves, mm-hmm. is it fair for just us to respect our own, we have respected it on BBI. People told us, we were going to remove clauses, mutilate the constitution, do everything mm-hmm. on this BBI. But then I think it is time then, if we are respecting this constitution, can we respect chapter 6 and be serious about it? Be very serious about it. That indeed, if you are in court, then why would you be cleared? And the ESCC has to be very firm on this one. If you're in court and you have a case going on, you don't need to be cleared. And it is very unfortunate. You know, the models and the values that we put out there, our young people are wondering, you told me this guy killed someone. Now, what is he doing up there? Asking for votes, and people are clapping for him. So it is something. First, I want to just thank you, Sam. You know, it's in this morning that we stopped politicians to go to church. And we want to thank the Bishop of All Saints Cathedral, ACK, for doing it now properly. That one started here. Today, we want to start a conversation here. Chapter 6. If indeed everyone demonized us, for those who were supporting BBI, we were told we are killing this country. Now, Chapter 6 is in the Constitution. It has to work. Mm-hmm. It has to work in this way. Number one, we must make sure, not just in court. Mm-hmm. If I'm coming to sign my form, declaration of my wealth, can it be a clear declaration of my wealth? Not the way we do things. And then in 2 years, you are very wealthy, but ESG has never remembered to go back and check.
Okay.
But they have the mandate and everything. Mm-hmm. But then lastly, now let me come to the issue of how do we move the politics to be inclusive? To be inclusive in the politics, we said, and that is why I think the team here is, was the whole BBI team. That is why we were calling for that inclusivity. Because we knew the moment you just give a president with this constitution the way it is, trust me, he will still do the same mistakes that happened, that has happened within our Jubilee government.
Okay.
That you will look at the team, you will give your cronies the seats of CSS and all that. So the why we have to appreciate that every region is going the way it is going. Why? It's because they want to come and sit now on the table. The same is the same thing we were trying to organize properly in law.
Yes, Alacha, allow me to cut it short so that Honorable Manzo can have the final word. And
okay, let me just finish in 1 second.
We're out of time. Please keep it short because presumption of innocence until proven guilty, but you must have exhausted all avenues of appeal. And one wonders where the Opio One Day Amendment will go. But then again, there's still that desire that people want to have credible leaders that are devoid of all these allegations of corruption. What do we do?
First, it must start with the people. The people must have a culture of rejecting people who are suspects, people who have participated in corruption and are known. It must begin with the people. And secondly, everyone is presumed innocent till proven guilty. And the moment you know you have rights of appeals, and that takes a long time. So I don't know where Wandae's law is going to go, but the theme of my very good friend Honorable Opio Wandae is that Kenyans and Kenyans, that we must really instill value through the church, through the school system, that Kenyans must learn now to not to elect Manzo if he's known to have participated in corruption, even if he has not yet been convicted in court.
Okay. Allow me to quickly look at the feedback that we have on Twitter.
Can I say one thing on one of the dangers of that law? Is that also we are in a country where not all prosecution is initiated bona fides. Because you will find Elachi today. You are in the newspaper. They are saying, "Oh, you have done this." And
yes, I'm told.
All it requires for you to be charged, and that's the end.
And that's the
All right. Let's take a look at the feedback. Tom Arodi, you're saying Tom Arodi, every person has only one vote. How did Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka get 1 million? These are the fallacies that make Kenyan political leadership to be assumed to belong to select individuals. 2023 is the year to upset these ones and for all.
He did get.
Jacob Abere, point of rebuttal.
He did get.
Funa, it's not rocket science. Party primaries, majority don't get right candidate. Why? Majority are given ticket in crooked ways because they are the ones who finance party activities. CEO Maskini. Njiti Nazaro, politics is all about personal interests. Parties are just vehicles to be used as a means of transportation to the next election. If SGC Fune is alluding that politicians are the problem in nominations, what has the party done to discipline such politicians? All the same, thumbs up for ODM for attempting to conduct the primaries, though the process is so pick.
Okay.
Jenga Wakongo, when in the history of Kenya's politics and political parties nominations, we'll ever have clear nominations. Kenyan political parties are political private companies under the individual management. That is why we'll never have strong parties whose agenda is development. Okelo Mwalimu, ODM must rectify its past mistakes, come up with bulletproof nomination system, court trustworthy partners, mobilize as many citizens as possible to register as voters. They must then popularize the presidential candidate by not antagonizing their former partners. Shouldn't that go to every other political party?
No, ODM is the only political party.
Come on, SG Sifuna. Honorable Nyonka, thank you so much for your time. CAS Elachi, SG Sifuna, and Honorable Manza for making time for us. Up next, just hold on, up next is Matters Social. The topic is housewife allowance. Watch. My name is Sam Gitoko. Bye for now.